for all of you ready to move to Eritrea. Sit down, let me talk to you. By now you've all heard that Eritrea passed a new law that all men must marry two wives. The story also says this is necessary because of the shortage of men in Eritrea due to the war. Something ain't right. But of course, my Nigerian people, Ghanaians, Kenyans, South Africans, Zimbabweans are ready to move to Eritrea to marry a second wife. Not this much, hey! Pule walele! Apule achiria titu! My friend will hear about this. Uncle Chidi, you too! Hey, whoa! By the way, I know this one, the one wearing white. We used to sing together in the choir. First of all, let me advise all of you that packed your load. All you have to do is take a critical look at the periphera of the photosynthesis of the story. The population of Eritrea is 6 million. 49.3% are men, while 50.7% are women. Look at that equation. That is almost the same amount of men and women. Even if Eritrean men decide to marry two wives each, where would the women come from? Second of all, they said the government will be paying for the wedding. Like, really? My brother, if you're not ready to get married, just tell us if you need help. But to think that somebody will take up your responsibility and be paying for your wedding, the devil is a liar. Of course, the story was made up. Polygamy is actually illegal in Eritrea. Several Eritreans have denied the authenticity of this story. Eritrean bloggers have been posting the Eritrean law that says polygamy is illegal in Eritrea. Even the government of Eritrea came out and said, this is not true. So yes, they do have enough men in Eritrea. But how did the fantasy begin? First of all, it was published by a Somalian website, and then a popular Kenyan website picked it up and it went viral. Remember that they already legalized polygamy in Kenya, so Kenyan men were very excited. Look at them, look at Kenyan men on their way to Eritrea. By the way, there was a Kenyan man that posted that photo and said these are Kenyan men because, you know, wait a minute, this is my personal person, but I'm only dressed to impress because you want to go to Eritrea. I saw one tweet, by the way, from a Bambino. He said, good morning from Accra, Eritrea. I said, this one, I can't even help him. Oh boy, you need to go back to school. This is the first Nigerian man to pick up his two wives from Eritrea. I thought I saw Kenya in that picture. Some people are thinking that this is what will happen when they get to Eritrea. Look at them surrounded by women. Unfortunately though, when some of them get to Eritrea, this is what will happen. Hey, yeah, look at his face. Look at this one. I feel sorry for our boys. Now this one is my favorite. Yes, back to back. Niger babes before me had to get Yala Yawa. Eritrean babes to take over. Ooh, snap, that reminds me of somebody. Who be that?
Baba Yaya, sweet to take over. And the fucking single was a hit. Back to back.
Man. Oh, by the way, Don Jazzy, on the other hand, was on his way to Eritrea. Have you seen all the Nigerian men in helicopters going to Eritrea? Can you fly in helicopter from one country to another country? The one good thing that came out of this hoax is that more people got to see and appreciate the beauty of Eritrean women. Yes, so yes, look at them, man. Very beautiful, eh? Take this now. No, me, I can't look at this one. But Amuri, I don't want to talk to him right now. I'm sure he got to Eritrea and found out the story is not true. He's looking for somebody to cry to. We'll talk next time. Shalom. Thanks for watching, guys. I'm having way too much fun. Ooh. Don't forget to check out my other videos, by the way. And of course, do not forget to subscribe. Nah. But Amuri, I'll talk to you after the service.